Okay, hello. It's been a while since I made a video, actually. Haven't really. It's just an update video. I know I've been doing a lot of them lately, but yeah, I thought I might just do an update on what's Well, there we go, all three computers on screen, so evidently. I've just been tidying up so I could record the video. You may notice something different in my room and on my channel as well. Some people may say I'm obsessed. Never mind. Go to my channel. You may notice. Oh no, it's gray! Well, that's not all new. I've decided to ditch the blue theme that I had. I like my title. It's so true, isn't it? I decided to, last time I uploaded a video, 1 week ago, probably over about nearly 2 weeks ago, probably. I decided to ditch the blue theme. Now what this theme also has a logo. I'm not making a background. Not making a background just yet. I don't know if I'll do one in the future, but it's just gray like this. When Christmas comes around for the month of December, I will put the Christmas theme back up. Not the background, probably not the background, but the logo, the intro, and the and a green background. But for regular ones, now this is going to be a question. What do you guys prefer? Do you prefer the I know I've got two names. I got the green one is the Christmas theme. The blue one is called the blue theme, and this gray one I call graphite. Yes, I hope Apple doesn't sue me for that, but I'm guessing they probably hold a patent on that name. But I'm calling it the graphite theme because it's gray, and I don't know, I like dark colors. So I thought I might just change my channel up a bit, and what else? Yeah, so tell me in the comments, what do you prefer? Do you prefer blue or the gray theme? Blue or graphite, so yeah, or blue or gray or whatever. What else? The intro, as you saw, I do have a gray version of my intro, so the graphite version of the intro. Next order of business. What else? So we've got the I'm guessing you probably know what that wallpaper's from anyway. It's actually pretty awesome. It's from my one of my all-time favorite operating systems. Your guessing time is over. It's actually Mac OS 10.2 Jaguar. Now Jaguar is actually my favorite version of OS 10 just because of the look of it, you know. I don't really like the brushed metal and all that, but anyway, that's besides the point. Next order of business is, you may notice something different here. Notice it yet? You have the same mouse, same keyboard, same speakers. What's this? It's a new monitor. Yep, there's my old one. There's nothing wrong with it. I got this new one. Now that's actually a TV there. I'm gonna go show you. I think I made a video of this one time, back in 2011, but I had a really crappy camera, the one I have now. I didn't even have a built-in light, but, it doesn't really do anything. But, this is a 22-inch, it's a 21.5, same size as the Medion. But it's a TV, it's my Onyx. Our next 22, it's code 22, but it's really 21.5 LED TV. It's a LED backlit, so yeah. You can see it's a TV. We have a VGA power, VGA audio, HDMI 2 and 3, component, composite out and composite in, and the regular TV tuner jack, which my camera is detecting as a face. You can't see that, but and we also got on the side here a USB port for the media, like plug in like a flash drive, and you can view what's on the flash drive. If format supported, HDMI 1 and another composite with audio, and a headset jack. Yeah, this it's still perfectly fine, but I decided to upgrade because well. Yeah, I call it an upgrade, even though it's a smaller screen. It's actually only a 19-inch, but, there's a remote to the TV. Because this monitor, it's a dedicated monitor. I haven't even given out the brand name yet. And I'm actually covering up the brand name of a flash drive, because I don't like the brand that this thing is. Yeah, it's got better color, and it also has something that I want, which is DVI. This monitor has a DVI port. I'm not using it on DVI, I'm actually using it on VGA right now, but... if I ever get a DVI cable, I'll use that, because both of these computers here have got DVI on them. And you may be thinking, oh, the AMD computer has DVI as well? I'll get to that in a minute. I'll put a new video card in it. But as you can see, I put the GeForce 6600 back in the optimal workflow after reapplying some new thermal paste, and it fixed it. So we've got DVI there. So if I ever get a DVI cable, I can use it. Same with that. We also got a DVI in there. It's got a new video card. So get to that later. But anyway, it's a 19-inch. Widescreen monitor. We have a resolution of 1440 by 900. That's my laptop is a 17.3 inch and 1600 by 900. So this is very similar. It's a 1440 by 900. I'm currently on the optimal work part right now, so Windows 8. Which Windows 8 actually worked better on a smaller screen, because you know, to get to the start menu, start screen, sorry. I know, I can just quickly just go here. Once you actually use Windows 8 for a little bit, you'll get used to it. Trust me, you will. I'm not telling you to go out and buy it, it's your choice. I don't even know if I'm gonna upgrade on my main computer or not. I don't know if I will. I can get it for $15 though, which is awesome. But GeForce 6600, I'm using the Nvidia driver now, not the Microsoft one. But monitor. Generic monitor. 60 hertz refresh rate. I think it's 75, but I'm just gonna keep on 60. But 1440 by 900. So anyway, may as well just say the brand of this monitor. And a lot of people hate this brand. Myself included, and that brand is Geyser. Yes, Geyser. It's actually Acer, but I hate Acer, and I hate them with a passion. But this their monitors, I've actually had problems with Acer computers in the past. My school back in 2009 bought like a whole batch of Acer Veriton desktops. They were brand new, basically. Had Pentium dual core E5200 in them. They're 2.5 gigahertz or something like that. And I think there's only today in 2012. I think there's only like about two left. They all died. Like power supplies blew up most of them, and some others just died. So I think there's only like two of them left. There was about 24. So it was 24, and there's only two left now. But this is even more versatile, because than the TV is. So we can move this. I can adjust it. Yep. The TV I could not adjust. It's fixed, basically. It's a fixed stand. I can adjust it. This I can tilt it, which is a big thumbs up in my opinion, because I don't want it too high, and I don't want it too low. Like, TV was just too low. It's got a higher stand that can adjust it. But it's a Geiser AL1916W. Means 19-inch widescreen. I think there's another YouTuber I think has the same monitor as this, but it's an AL1716W, I think. But his one is has a black bezel, but a glossy screen. That's 17-inch, but same screen resolution. But his monitor works really well. The other thing that this has is better color than the TV did. I could not, with the TV, the menu system on that TV is just absolutely retarded. I cannot adjust the color in the VGA mode, but I can adjust it in the HDMI and TV modes. I can adjust it in the HDMI and TV, but not the VGA mode, which sucked. And basically, if you when you set it in one mode, it would only stick in that actual mode for that actual port. Like, for HDMI 1, if I set the color settings and put it into HDMI 2, it'd be different in HDMI 2 than it is HDMI 1. It's a very stupid system, and I didn't like it. This has got better color, though. And it's a dedicated monitor rather than having a TV. I know it's less resolution, I know it's smaller size, but I actually prefer the smaller screen compared to the bigger one. It fits better on my desk. I prefer it, and yeah, it's got a really good picture too. And it's always doing something with the floppy drive. What else? So that's that monitor. It says Geiser there. I hate Acer with a passion, but you know. The monitors are not too bad. I've never had a problem with their monitors. Actually, back in 2010, I actually got one of these identical monitors for free. I got one for free. It was the exact same model, but it had a dead backlight, so I threw it. I chucked it because it had a dead backlight, but it was identical to this one. It even had the little "Designed for Windows Vista" sticker on the base. Had that too. But I got that monitor for free, identical to this, but it had dead backlight, so I chucked it. Because I could tell it worked, because when I plugged it in, if I held a flashlight to it, I could see what was on the screen from the computer I connected it to. But the backlight just didn't work. Even slapping the back of it didn't do anything. That's what she said. Actually, that's not what she said. And what else? I can't really think of anything else. Any updates? The Medion's doing just fine. Oh yes, the AMD computer. I put a new graphics card in it. I'm gonna have to plug everything in to show you, but actually, why not? Let's just this video's probably long enough anyway, so why not make it a little longer, right? Let's have a look. Okay. Inside the AMD machine, we have, he's saying, "Where's the graphics card? It's on the AGP slot." It's actually a PCI graphics card. And you may be thinking, a PCI graphics card with DVI? Yep. And Windows Error support? Uh-huh. This is an NVIDIA GeForce 6200. I pulled it out of that machine. If you're wondering what that computer is, that's actually the Pentium 4 custom-built computer that belongs in the living room. I was actually doing some maintenance on it because the clock battery was dead and it doesn't work. Even though I changed it, it still doesn't keep the date and time. I gotta fix that. Don't know what the problem is. But I put a new graphics card in that. I put an ATI Radeon 9600 because that ATI Radeon, I have an ATI Radeon 9600 video card. But the problem was with that card, it works in Asus boards, but not Gigabyte motherboards. Every Gigabyte motherboard I've used that card on does not work. This one has a Gigabyte motherboard, doesn't work. The motherboard that I'm using That I'm going to use for my XP gaming rig, which is in my closet. It actually used to be a system. I had a case and everything, but the case was so beat up I chucked it. Tried that video card in it, didn't like it. And my sister's computer, which is also a Gigabyte motherboard. She has a Celeron box. I know, it's kind of cruel that I gave her a Celeron, but I got no other OGA 775 chips lying around. And if I did, that would be a mess. That's also got a Gigabyte board. Tried it in that, does not work. So, but that video card worked on my Pentium 3 computer, my old Asus Pentium 3. It worked perfectly in that, and this has an Asus board in it, and it works perfectly. So, I don't know, it's picky. But, yeah. So, I wanted to have a decent graphics card in this thing. And I'm going in there now. No, I know I'll have some viewers saying, "None of everything you have is crap and you're gay." Well, to that I say, well, that's, well, if you think that, well, go ahead. Anyway, I'm probably rambling now, and that stupid son of a bitch cover fell off. Oh well. Okay. Anyway. So, that is computer updates for, I forget what the date is. What is the date? October 7th. So, I hope you enjoyed this. Sorry if the video was too long for you to watch. I apologize. I tend to ramble. And, that computer's doing just fine. I haven't changed anything on it. I haven't changed anything on this computer either, except for that NVIDIA GeForce card I put in it. The 6600 I put back in it. But that's, gave that a 6200. I did the channel update. New monitor. And that's about it. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Alright. Till then.